The Electoral Commission roadmap for the 2026 general elections indicates that the process began on 3rd June this year with benchmarking on electoral participation by citizens in the diaspora, prison, persons with disabilities and special institutions.
I'm Peter Kudis, Honorable Minister. I want to thank you for raising those issues. And I want to recognize the efforts by the entities or organizations of persons with disabilities who on regular occasions engage with the Commission and seeking to address the issues that pertain to the peculiar issues that pertain to their elections and their votes. I must apologize, we should have provided for the sign language interpreter for this ceremony.
The Electoral Commission, this time, let us have sign language interpreters. Whether you can employ them so that they become permanent as your staff for the time being of this map, so that they can have quality of what you want than picking every time now and then.
The roadmap further entails the following. Between 3rd April 2024 to 1st June 2024, they will carry out procurement of materials and services for the demarcation and reorganization of polling stations. Between 29th May 2024 to 27th June 2024, they will carry out recruitment, training and deployment of parish and sub-county supervisors for the purpose of reorganizing of the polling stations. From 13th June 2024 to 15th June 2024, National Training Workshop for Staff on Commencement of Roadmap and Reorganizing Gaining Polling Stations will take place. Field demarcation of constituencies and electoral areas will be held between 4th July 2024 to 13th July 2024. General update of the register in each parish will run between 3rd January 2025 up to 24th January 2025. Display of the National Voters Register at each polling station will happen between 18th February 2025 to 8th May 2025. Deadline for the registration of public servants intending to contest is between 2nd August 2025 and 13th June 2025. Verification of academic papers for presidential, parliamentary and local government leaders will be held between 3rd July 2025 and 1st August 2025. Nomination, campaigns and polling for the National Youth Council committees will be held between 27th August 2025 to 29th August 2025. Nomination of candidates for local governments will take place between 3rd September 2025 to 12th September 2025. Nomination of candidates in Parliament will take place between 16th September 2025 to 17th September 2025. Nomination of candidates for presidential elections will be held between 2nd October 2025 to 3rd October 2025. According to the roadmap, polling for presidential, parliamentary and local government councils will be held between 12th January 2026 to 9th February 2026. However, a section of the public, mostly politicians, have raised mixed reaction over this roadmap, with some alleging that the NRM party almost already started on the campaigns, yet other parties are not allowed.
The NRM Electoral Commission, which I head, has 2,500,000 to fill. So we have a bigger job and we can start earlier than you. So we are also putting the others on tenterhooks. That don't blame us that we are campaigning early. We are only going to release our roadmap, and the chairman of the party will lead us in this exercise.
So we are informing the police not to stop us because your boss is also campaigning. So for us, we are also in campaign mode. We appreciate the roadmap, but let the security people know that we are already in campaign mode. 2 years is such a short time if you are going to campaign for presidential elections.
The confidence to Ugandans that this strategic plan, it is very unique in East Africa. Why? It is Uganda only having a platform of political parties for dialogue and consensus building.
Uganda last held general elections in 2021. The Electoral Commission is established under Article 60 and mandated under Article 61 of the Constitution of the Republic of Uganda 1995 to organize, conduct and supervise regular, free and fair elections and referenda, among other functions. Report compiled by Jaliat Namwaya for the news.